Our next lesson is about variables and input parameters. We called this lesson Programmer's Nuke, but don't worry, we are not going to code anything. The thing is that variables are used in all programming languages. So first of all, let's explain variables, and later we will talk about input conditions, and then we are going to show you some examples right in the software. So what is variable? Basically, the variable is information. Very simply put, kind of category where we put a value, let's say number 10, and every time and everywhere we look at this category, it always has the value we set, so 10. In strategies, we use variables every time when we need to access or change a value or information at more places of the strategy. For example, yesterday's price range, magic number, or open range. And here we have types of variables. First one is string. It's ordered sequences of characters. For us, it may be, for example, comment from the trade log. Boolean, it's a very basic variable, 0 or 1 or true or false. For us, it may be an information if a condition is valid or not. Double, it's a number with a decimal point, and we are going to use this one for price, for example, like $2.5, $2.8, and so on. Then we have integer, like a whole number without a decimal point, like 1, 2, 3, etc. And we will use it to refer, for example, to candles. 2 candles ago, 3 candles ago. And there is never double number. It is true that variables are mostly for most advanced users, and you're not going to use it in the default, but later, when we are going to create a template, for example, we will definitely need it. It would be great to keep in your mind that you can find this table here, right in this lesson, so anytime you would need it, you can easily access it. Now, input parameters. I bet that input parameters are familiar for most of you because everyone who did ever launch a trading robot in a platform. So before launching, or if you will click on F7, you can see this window with settings and bookmark inputs. Here you can see custom comment and of what type is this variable? Right, it's string. The next one is magic number. And yep, you are right, it's integer. Well, and these are the inputs that we can set here. And if we set them, we can use them in our strategy as comments or calculation or as information like magic number. But attention, we can't change inputs. We can change only variables. We will show you the difference just in a moment. But now let's move to strategy quant. So here you can see the strategy, simple moving average 200. And what you are going to do is to add new and very easy variable. First of all, let's see what we have here. So we have here variables and 5 parameters. First one is magic number. When this button is blue, it means the parameter is allowed with value 111. Then we have here long entry signal, short entry signal, long and short exit signal. Well, and the magic number is the input. If we would switch back to the platform, it's right, this magic number 111. And custom comment is here at the top. To see our value here, we have to switch it on here, right in the software, so this button would be blue. And then we can anytime access this value. If you would take a look at bookmarks, this magic number identifier of the robot is used while we send an order to a market, when we open a position, so we need it. Here I could put it manually, but we already set it here in the variables. So just like this, you can add here, for example, moving average period. So I'm going to right here MA period. I also have to switch it on. And it is also integer with default value 200 and click on close. And in the bookmark trading signals, when we define the period, we could switch it and click on MA period. If we would start a backtest, nothing really changes. Everything is the same. But right at the moment, we would launch the robot in the platform. You can modify to 220, 230, and the robot will use the value we set. These are the inputs. And once more, the input has to be switched on here. In case it would be switched off, it would not be displayed while launching the robot in the platform. And in this list, wouldn't be the numbers. These are so-called variables that we can use just as we need. And also, it is good to set these variables here in the bookmark calculation and then use them in the other bookmarks. Now, let me show you a quick and easy example. I'm going to calculate the period that we use here in this first bookmark. So I click on Add First Action, choose here Action Assigned Variable, click on Confirm, and this action will allow us to add values to the variables. Now I choose the MA period, and here I can choose that it's gonna be number 200. And the number 200 appears also here. Or if I would choose it here and click on the formula and choose also here MA period, then click on confirm, then both here and here the values are 200. But I can do it much more difficult, and that's the main purpose. And I can use here function as multiplication and calculate the MA period as a multiple of some indicator. Here I use number, for example, 20, and here I choose ATR, average true range. And like this, at the beginning of the candle, the bookmark calculation will launch under the MA period, would be say the value 20, multiplied by the value of ATR indicator, and then this value is used in different bookmarks. Well, this construction doesn't make much sense indeed, but the point is the principle. Sooner or later, you will use this and you will need to use values across all of these bookmarks. I guess you won't want to calculate the value separately for every bookmark, and using this method, you will reach it. So, this was a quick introduction to variables and inputs. And now let's move to the next lesson.